what I believe the challenge is going to be, any recruiter that makes a living on LinkedIn alone is going to find it's a finite universe real quick, and it's being beat on by a lot of people. Take a private talent warehouse, say like someone like myself or any recruiter that has their own bucket where they put people in. Where did they get their people from? Well, some I got from LinkedIn, some I got from the bus stop, some I met at a bar, some I met on a career board. So the point is that my bucket will always be greater than the next thing that comes around. LinkedIn today, Plaxo yesterday, I don't know what the next thing's going to be. It's branch out now on Facebook, and there's another one, and it's never ending. But one thing I could tell you, they could all come and go, but the important people in my world are in my own private database. I'll never put my private database on LinkedIn. I will just take people from LinkedIn and put it in mine. Therefore, so LinkedIn, it has its limitations. With that being said, I think that Promptivate isn't just limited to going to the LinkedIn pool. It could point at any barrel. It could point at any bucket.
Yeah.
And so the fact that it's proved out or can be used in my personal network on LinkedIn, that's great. But what I have in private is an aggregate of LinkedIn and all my other sources. That tool needs to be Promptivated way more than LinkedIn.
Yeah.
LinkedIn's a subset of the entire picture. So I think that's the biggest issue. And then, so I know it's a long story, but LinkedIn kind of ran its course. Unfortunately, I give LinkedIn another, I'm on camera, I give it another 5 years.
We won't tell them to.
Well, we won't tell them that we're going to buy them eventually and change it up. But, we'll be,
Do that in 2 years, hire me, and I'm in.
That's awesome.
Well, great, Scott. This is really great. We've spoken with several different recruiters and gotten some good feedback, but I continue to learn new things. So you gave some new, good stuff, especially on, it all comes down back to the relationships and the strength of individual relationships and how the extra time spent makes a difference and pays off in the long run.
There's no doubt about it. And one last thing I'd like to add.
Absolutely.
And that is regarding the one of the core concepts that I believe too is the strength is frequency of touch of these relationships. So if I said that I talked to Drew, hey, we talked two times now. I met you once.
Yep.
Talked to you on the phone once, and this is the third time. Over time, starting to get to know you. And, the first two times, I could say, hey, it was a nice guy. I had a good first impression. And then we met in person, and that was, or did we? I'm not even certain. Or maybe me and Steve did. Or, you met and you had to leave early.
Yeah.
The point I'm trying to make is, over a frequency of time, it would be nice to see my dashboard of maybe all my contacts and say, Steve Harper contacted 3 times in all of 2012. 3 outbound attempts to reach, no inbound pingbacks. Drew Bixby, 18 attempts to reach, 7 times return. I might start to see the true relationships come out. I might think I have 300 relationships. I might try to reach them all the time. At some point, I've got a false sense of security because those people aren't seeing me the way I'm seeing them.
Exactly. And that's definitely where we want to go.
Yeah.
Absolutely. That's part of the big picture. Don't give me all.
Perfect. Yep. All right, cool, guys. This is great. I'm